The financial markets are now betting against a Melbourne Cup Day interest rate rise after lower than expected inflation figures. But that's no guarantee. Mortgages won't go up.
Entering stage right, NAB's boss left no doubt his strategy of slashing fees is paying off.
And we're seeing quite pleasing growth, you know, transaction accounts growing strongly and mortgages and other things, which I think is a sign that customers do respond to, you know, what is a good offer.
Offering an alternative to the bigger banks' fee structures has helped yield a $4 billion annual profit, up 63% on last year. Bad debts are down, but the cost of funding is on the up.
The average cost of funding is rising. The marginal cost has stabilised, and that's pleasing, but the average cost is rising as we roll off cheaper pre-GFC funding and roll into more expensive post-GFC funding.
NAB's better-than-expected profit came as weaker-than-expected inflation numbers took the chance of a Melbourne Cup Day interest rate rise from even odds to a long shot.
On financial markets, the chance of an official rise fell from 50 to just 14%, as inflation for the September quarter increased by just 0.7%, and annual inflation fell back within the central bank's target zone.
After today's pretty benign inflation numbers, we think that the Reserve Bank will remain on hold.
The Treasurer happy to look a gift horse in the mouth.
This is the lowest underlying inflation rate in 5 years.
But it doesn't guarantee the big banks won't raise their rates independently.
They want to raise their mortgage rates. They've been signalling that time and time again over the last few months. This now makes it a bit more difficult for them to do that.
I can't really speculate on what competitors might do on Cup Day.
And yourself?
I can't speculate on what we'll do either.
Jacqueline Maddock, 10 News.